A computer system uses the collection of the binary digit, that is called the 0 and 1, to represent data and instruction, which is called as the machine language code. Okay. Like earlier, I told you that computer only know the 0 and 1 format. Computer doesn't understand any other value. Okay, like if you press the plus, then it is converted to the 10, 150, then 100. So when you use subtract, then it is converted to the 10, 130, then 130. Okay, so it means what? When you give any instruction to the computer, computer doesn't understand any value, it convert it into the 0 and 1 format. So when you press the simple plus is converted to this number. Okay. So if you give that text to the computer, to the human being, that you have to remember this line, then it is not possible. Amuku jodi koha jibo je instead of remember the plus, you remember this number for adding, which is quite impossible for a human brain to remember this number. As you also know that we store the contact number in the form of a name, because it is not possible. We are contacted with the number of people. So it is not possible to gather all the value. So therefore, to give a instruction to the computer into the 0 and 1 format, we're using high level programming language. So I'm directly konosi value 0 or 1 format re ame computer ko pass kari pariba nahi, as because it is impossible to remember this number. So that we are using this programming language to give the instruction to the computer. So therefore, we use the high level programming language to write the code. A high level programming language is what? Now it consists of set of instruction which are represented using simple English word. So we're using some simple English word to give a instruction to the computer. So when we communicate with each other, okay, so ame jeta bele kotha artha hoche, so we use some language, like we use English, we use Hindi, we use Odia. Okay. And each language has a vocabulary and grammar. So every language contains some vocabulary and grammar. So you know the English language, you know Hindi. So every language contains some kind of rules. So that rules is called as the grammar. The similar way, when you write a program, your program is follow some kind of rules. Okay. So that rule is called as the syntax of the program or grammar of the program. Okay. So Gibson heading, what is syntax? To write the program, we follow, to write a program, Gibson heading, write it. Syntax, what is syntax? To write a program, we have to follow some rules. that rule is called as vocabulary and grammar. So, what are the languages we are using? So, ame jete bele communication koruche, we are using Hindi, we are using Odia, we are using English. Similar way, when you give the instruction to the computer, you have to follow some programs. So, through some program, you have to provide the instruction. So, what are the programs are there? One is C, C++, Java. So these are the programming language we're using. So each language has a vocabulary and grammar. So every language contains some vocabulary and grammar. The next, we move that vocabulary and grammar is called as the syntax of the program. So now there is a question. Is computer know all the languages? Answer is no. Computer doesn't know any languages. As because computer only know the 0 and 1 format. So earlier I mean discuss kartele, they have plus symbol pai, addition pai, subtraction pai. So that means what are the instructions we are providing? This converted into the 0 and 1 format. The computer madhya, amar se 0 and 1 format re se mone rakhibo. So ame jo programming language provide kariba. Is the programming language computer is knowing the programming language? Answer is no. Computer jodi language sikhibo, so computer must have to go some kind of institution, some kind of college, some kind of school. The computer doesn't go anywhere. We have to use the computer anywhere. So that to use the computer to pass the syntax, we have to, or we convert this programming language into this 0 and 1 format by using a translator. So that translator is called as the compiler. The compiler is nothing but it is called the translator. So this translator convert the programming language into the machine language. To convert the programming language into the machine language, we're using compiler. Okay, so I show you the program. Let's check. Okay, so see that this part is called as the what? It is asking a question. What question it is asking? It is asking, but can a computer understand the instruction written in a particular programming language? Answer is no. The computer doesn't understand any kind of programming language. Computer only understand the 0 and 1 format. Then how the computer will know this one? See that a computer cannot understand the instruction written in a particular programming language. To solve this problem, a special program called as compiler is used. तो जिम्ति के मुकाबली कंप्यूटर कौनसी प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज बुझी पा रहे हैं आज कंप्यूटर ओनली अंडरस्टैंड जीरो एंड वन फॉर्मेट इफ यू वांट टू पास एनी इंस्ट्रक्शन इनटू द जीरो एंड वन फॉर्मेट देन इट इज क्वाइट इम्पॉसिबल ए ह्यूमन ब्रेन कैन नॉट रिमेंबर द नंबर सो दैट वी आर टेकिंग द हेल्प ऑफ प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज सो थ्रू द प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज वी आर पासिंग द इंस्ट्रक्शन देन देर इज अ क्वेश्चन अराइजेस Is computer know all the programming language? Answer is no. Computer doesn't know any programming language. Then how computer will understand what the instruction we are passing? Computer is understand the instruction that we are passing by using a special program that is called the compiler. So it means what? If you notice that our Prime Minister when going to the United Nation, they address India people in Hindi. The India, जो सेमाने US जाएं कि सेमाने कौन करों थे ना हिंदी रखूं थे. Is all person is capable to know the Hindi? Answer is no, because lot of country means we have 250 country and 250 country peoples are coming in the meeting, and at that timing, Prime Minister trying to speak in Hindi. So is all person knowing Hindi? No. Every person know the English. So how they come to understand? So they come to understand because of they use a translator. If you notice there, they using a headphone. So that headphone translating this Hindi language into English. So they translating Hindi language into English so that they other person or other people present in this meeting, they able to understand it. So similar way, the computer doesn't understand any programming language. We give the instruction to the computer by using a programming language, but computer doesn't understand any kind of programming language. So for that reason, we're using a compiler. Compiler convert the programming language into the machine language. It convert the programming language into the machine language. So compiler process the statement written in particular language and convert them into machine language. The process of translating programming language code into machine language code is called as the compilation. The process of converting programming language to the machine language code is called as the compilation. Okay, so you first write what is compiler. Compiler means translator. So first gives an heading compiler. It process the statement, right? It process the statement written in particular programming language. And convert them into machine language. Then next point, the process of translating programming language code, the process of translating programming language code into machine language code is called as a compilation. If you see this figure, we're using A add B. A is adding B, it gives a result C. A add B, it gives a result C. It is called as a programming language. A add B, it gives you C, is called as a programming language. To convert this program, we're using a compiler. The compiler convert the programming language into the machine language. Compiler convert the programming language into the machine language. So here we're using compiler. So if we add A add B equals 3, this converted into the 0 and 1 format, this one. It convert it into the 0 and 1 format. Okay. Now it is a question for you. Okay, so Subhasri and Subhalakshmi can tell. A DAS is a special program that convert the programming language into the machine language at one go. Question is, option is input process output cycle, central processing unit and compiler. किए आमर प्रोग्रामिंग लैंग्वेज टा को मशीन लैंग्वेज रे कन्वर्ट करे
सर कंपाइलर
यस सुभालक्ष्मी
ऑप्शन आते
रहे ये देखो इंपोर्ट प्रोसेस आउटपुट साइकिल Central processing unit. Next is compiler.
Output cycle.
Compiler. The compiler is a special program. Compiler कौन करे? Compiler का work होचे translating जुड़ा लिखी दो. से कौन करीबा हमार programming language टा को machine language रे convert करीबा. बुझा ला? So next I move to second session. To solve the problem, computer program, it is nothing but it is a problem. Okay. To give a solution, we're using algorithm, flowchart, and pseudocode. Computer is nothing but, it is a problem. So when you have a problem, you have to give a solution. जमती के घरे अमर इलेक्ट्री गोटे तार रे बा गोटे प्लग रे इलेक्ट्री आसछ कि नाही केमती हमें चेक करिवा ये कोई परबो गोटे प्लग किमा स्विच रे इलेक्ट्री आसछ कि नाही हमें केम चेक करूचे गुड सुभाश्री
सर लो चार्ट
हम टेस्टिंग करू ना ओटे करंट आसी कि नहीं घरे जतले टेस्टर माने पड़ला स्क्रू बोले दियो सो जे को लाइट आसी हम जानि परबा जेडी करंट आसी ओके द टेस्टर इज डूइंग दैट वर्क द टेस्ट थ्रो बाय यूजिंग ऑफ टेस्टर वी आर व्हाट यूजिंग इट we are testing whether the electricity has come or not. The tools that we can use to represent the procedure to solve a problem is algorithm, flowchart, and pseudocode. So there is three type of tools we are using. One is algorithm, flowchart, and pseudocode. The tools that is used to solve a problem is called as the algorithm, flowchart, and pseudocode. So right? The tools that is used to represent the procedure, the tools which is used to solve a problem and is algorithm, flowchart, and pseudocode. Here you notice that what is that algorithm? Algorithm is a sequence of steps to solve a problem. So it is a sequence of steps to solve a problem, and algorithm ends after fixed number of steps. Every algorithm ends after fixed number of steps. Each steps in the algorithm clearly specify the action to be performed. Algorithm ends after fixed number of steps. So every problem is having some kind of set of solution. Okay, suppose I want to make a tea. For preparing a tea, I have to follow some kind of step. Ame kichi step follow kole tapare ame cha paiba. So first ame milk ku garam kariba, tapare sugar pakeiba, then taku boil kariba, then we are getting a tea. So we are following some kind of step. Algorithm is just like that. It ends after fixed number of steps. Each steps in an algorithm clearly specify the action to be performed. In every step, it contains what you have to do. It clearly specify the action to be performed. The steps in an algorithm specify the basic operation. These operation can include calculation, input-output operation, and comparison. Okay, so every step, it contains the calculation. Okay, so each steps in the algorithm specify action to be performed. The algorithm, every step, what we have to do. The steps in the algorithm. So when you write the steps in the algorithm, it contains some basic step. Co-step driver. So in this step, it is asking some kind of input. It is asking some kind of what? Processing. Then it is generating the output. Or some step, it contains the comparison. In algorithm, accept the input data in a defined format before it can be processed. Okay, so for storing a value, algorithm accept the input. Okay, ame kethi kon kahile na algorithm contain in algorithm it contain the set of step. In that step it contain input and output operation. In input it will take the information or it will take the data from the user. So when it will take the data from the user, for storing the value we require a container. We require a container. So in that container we store the value. An algorithm generate one or more output after the input is processed. So you can say that which container you require. Ghare jodi ame water ba pani piwa, So we take the glass, we can take the water in a cup. Okay, so when you take the water in a cup, it is not what? Finish your thirsty. When you want to eat curry, so you are taking a bowl. If you want to take rice, you have to take a plate. So rice and roti that you cannot take with the cup. So cup re ami ta khai paribani. So for every specific region where use the specific container. For taking a tea, we are using cup, milk cup. For drinking water, we require a glass. The similar way, when you want to store the information, you have to store in a defined format. An algorithm generate one or more output after the input is processed. The result and input store as an output, which is stored in a another location. For why we are storing the information? Because it is used for future purpose. An algorithm follow the IPO cycle to solve a problem. It also follow the IPO cycle to solve a problem. Okay, so this is the characteristics of the algorithm. So in next class, I will show you how to write a algorithm. Okay, so just a minute, I show you some small program. See that it is a algorithm which is used to withdraw the amount from ATM. For withdraw the amount from ATM, see that what the step we have to perform: start the algorithm and end the algorithm. So every algorithm contain the start and ending position. Insert your ATM card. The ATM machine checks your card detail whether your card is correct or not. Enter the PIN number. You give a PIN number. The ATM machine validates the PIN number. It will check that the PIN number you have given, it is correct or not. Ama PIN number ta se validate karibo. Then print cash with receipt button. Then select the amount you want to withdraw. Then collect your ATM card after getting your money. The ATM machine count the cash, so there is some sound. What is sound of a cash balance? Collect the amount from ATM, jo paisa wala collect kariba. Then after that, you have to collect the receipt. Then end of the algorithm. It is a simple step to write an algorithm to withdraw the amount from ATM. For withdrawing the amount from ATM, there is a simple step we are performing. Clear? Bujhela? Subha Lakshmi, Subha Sri. Okay, so you write a question and give it to me. The kariki mate dekheba. Write an algorithm. A step ko follow kariki. Write an algorithm. Take two number, add it and display the result. Write an algorithm, take two number, add it and display. Okay. Okay. So in the next class Monday, I will go ahead. Okay. इटा मते कॉरी के WhatsApp रे पढ़ेगा. ठीक है जी. चलो. Bye bye. ठीक है. Bye bye.
Yes, sir.